Hi, I'm Stu, and welcome back to another LumaFusion video tutorial. Today, we're going to be looking at the new stabilisation feature in LumaFusion version 3.0. So let's get started. First of all, just to give you a quick tour of what's going on, I've got no stabilisation on the red clip below. And then in this clip, which I've just duplicated, we're going to go in and we're going to take the word no away, because this is where I'm going to be applying stabilization. And then all you've got to do is select the clip you want to stabilize and tap on the pencil icon. And you'll see down at the bottom, we've got our frame and fit, speed and reverse, audio settings, and color and effects. And smack bang in the middle now is stabilize. LumaFusion have given you three sort of default presets, one being actually called default, second strong, third light, and then there's a duplicate, but this time with shutter correction switched on. The stabilizer itself has been powered by CoreMelt, so LumaTouch are licensing their technologies and putting it directly into LumaFusion for you. So any updates that CoreMelt apply to their stabilizing will also get applied to the stabilizer within LumaFusion, and you'll benefit from that. If you're going to do it manually, then literally tap stabilize. You'll see that's how quickly it processes through using the new iPad with the M1 chip. Only takes a second, and by default, it gives you 0.7. If you went for strong, it would go to 1.0, and if you went for light, it would be 0.25. As you can see, there's a new user interface over here on the right hand side, and if we tap the little pencil icon, we've got this calculator this time where we can make adjustments. So for example, if I wanted to sort of not be light but not be strong, then I could tap 0.5, or I could literally type in 0.40 and it makes the connection on the top right, and then press enter. That gets applied if you're using your keyboard. If not, just literally tap enter, tap the X, and that's the setting then applied. Now, this video clip is actually part of two clips, an A and a B, a wide shot, a tighter shot that I made using Filmic Pro's double take app. We're using the wide shot just now. If we just tap the arrow to go back, I'll play through the stabilized clip, which is a little bit smoother. And just to show you a sort of before and after, I'm going to go into frame and fit, and I'm going to go down to cropping, and I'm going to crop up from the bottom so you can see the correction that's actually been made. And once again, if I wanted 50%, all I've got to do is go into pencil icon, tap 50, and then get out of it. So the top part of the video clip is stabilized, the bottom part is handheld and not stabilized. Tap back out, and then we play through. Now, I should say at this point, I wouldn't use all 6 seconds of this clip. This is literally 1.5 seconds maximum, and then I'm cutting away to another clip, but it gives you a good idea of what's going on with the stabilization. And also, I didn't use a gimbal here because I wanted a handheld vibe, but there's handheld and then there's smoother handheld, and that's what the stabilization's there for. You can see the difference in the positioning and what CoreMelt have actually done to smooth out your clip. Again, if you want to make any further adjustments, you can double tap your clip, go to stabilize, and then make any changes. So for example, we could switch on automatic shutter correction, which I assume is for rolling shutter. You can also control the individual horizontal strengths, vertical, rotational, and the zoom strength. If you want to, you've also got advanced scaling, which plays with how much it actually crops in, and just by double tapping it sets it back to 0.8 as a default. You can choose to go fixed and zoom in or zoom out. I wouldn't worry too much about that. I would tend to use the smart option. And then finally, you've got the advanced margin, where you can actually fill the margin in with black or repeated video clip. We'll go into these in more depth in another video tutorial. This is just an overview today to let you see one of the new features within LumaFusion 3.0. And if we tap to go back out, I'll play the clip through again. So the bottom part, not stabilized, top part, stabilized. And that's how you use video stabilization by CoreMelt within LumaFusion 3.0. Hope you've enjoyed this video tutorial. If you have, give it a thumbs up. If I've earned your subscription today, subscribe, and don't forget to ring that bell so you get notified next time there's a video tutorial. See you later.